Hey, everybody. Hope you are doing well. Okay, so today is May 26th, and I've been doing these happy birthday tributes for a little while now. Today is kind of chock full of people who I'd want to give a shout out to for their birthday. The list is so long that honestly, I just can't do videos for each and every single one of them because it would just take too long. So I do want to shout out a group of people, and then I'm going to play one artist in particular whose birthday would be May 26th. The list is so long, I had to write it down. So from very, very, very long time ago, we've got Isadora Duncan, Peggy Lee, and Al Jolson, going all the way back to the 30s and 40s and so on. And then, sort of in the 70s time period, you got Stevie Nicks, Mick Ronson, you know, Mick Ronson of David Bowie and the Spiders from Mars, Levon Helm, best known for the band, and of course, Hank Williams Jr. And then you also have Lauryn Hill and Lenny Kravitz. So all of those people were born on May 26th, which kind of make you wonder if May 26th is sort of a special day for artists to be born. Kind of is. I mean, it's 8, 7, 8, 9 people there, right? Today's video, however, is going to be presented in the name of one of my all-time favorites and a true legend in a genre, Mr. Miles Davis. So today we're going to do a live performance of the song Splatch by Miles Davis. This is going to feature a very young Robben Ford on guitar. And because it's a live video, I've shrunken the box down a bit to hopefully not deal with any sort of copyright BS that could go along with it. I don't know if it's going to go through or not. So got to give it a shot here. But anyway, here is the happy birthday boy, Mr. Miles Davis, and the song Splatch live. Thank you. What a killer groove. What a live performance. Wow. There's a few cool moments that I kind of want to point out real quick. First thing is one right about here where you see something you didn't often see or hear about with a Miles Davis performance. And that's Miles Davis actually acknowledging or even to a certain extent facing the audience. Check this out. There's this little fill here, and then he waves. Watch this. I mean, he was famous for not playing towards the audience. There's a lot of moments, and you can see it in the rest of the song. There's a lot of instances where his back is to the audience. He's just walking back and forth. He's not facing them hardly ever at all. You know, he does a couple of little waves. That was the biggest, most obvious one caught on camera. But it's really a unique moment in the, you know, sort of the history of Miles Davis. A lot of times he played with his back to the audience. And at first there was some controversy to that. And then, of course, it's Miles. It's what he did. I mean, there's tons of stories out there about Miles Davis and how he ran his band and how he performed live and whether he liked or disliked the audience or how he felt about it. I mean, he definitely had some feelings of being racially discriminated against, which, again, during the time that he was around, totally understandable why he would feel that way. In many instances. Look at the size of this crowd. I mean, look at the size of this crowd. It's packed. And I don't know whether this is a jazz festival or if it's actually for him. In other words, if he, you know, again, he's one of the biggest names in jazz music. So, you know, but that's a football stadium. And it's full. It's a huge crowd. I mean, look at the sheer mass of people out there that he's playing to. It's gigantic. You know, look at that. I don't know what stadium it is, but it's a massive amount of people for a jazz show. Whether it's a football stadium, could be a baseball stadium, I suppose. I can't quite make out any of the signs in the background. It's a little blurry, old film footage and what have you. And then there's another really killer moment right about here where he goes and gets Robben Ford and brings him out front. And then after a couple of seconds, he just stands there and watches Robben play. And it's right about here, shortly after he takes a drink of water here, where he gets Robben and he walks him to the front of the stage as if to say, okay, you take it, kid. But think about this. He's a young guy. Okay, this is probably mid-80s, somewhere in there. That's basically 40 years ago, right? So how old could Robben Ford have been? 20s? Early 20s, somewhere in there. And he's on stage with one of the true legends of the jazz music world. Guy who, although he was a bit of a curmudgeon at times in his career, did like a good guitar player. He had people like Robben Ford in his band. He had Mike Stern in his band. He had John Scofield in his band, just to name a few. And he would... You know, there were stories like I think there's one story where he walked up to Mike Stern while they were in playing, and he just whispered to him in that gravelly voice, "He's like, Mike, give me some Hendrix." It's like, and he's like, "Okay, got to play some Hendrix stuff," while you know, performing this song. The song's going on. He's got to improvise some Hendrix stuff. So this moment here, I'm just wondering how nervous you got to be. When this is going on, where he's got his arm around your shoulder, he's dragging you to the front of the stage, you got to play some licks, and he's then going to stand there in the front of the stage and just watch you and stare at you. And I'm sitting there thinking to myself as I'm watching this, how did he feel? Like, did he feel Miles's eyes on him? Look at this. Watch this. Arm over the shoulder. Come on, front boy. Come on. Get out here. Come on, son. Come on. front of the stage. I'm still not looking up at the audience. I'm playing my trumpet. And then I'm going to turn away and say, you take it. You go. And I'm going to turn around and I'm going to watch. I mean, that must have been an incredibly cool moment, but I wonder what the pressure might have felt like in those instances for a young kid like Robben was at this time. Anyway, it's a cool video, right? Just want to wish not only Miles Davis, but all the rest of the people, you know, again, Lenny Kravitz, Hank Williams Jr., Brenda Lee, Al Jolson, Isadora Duncan, Levon Helm, Stevie Nicks, and Mick Ronson, and Miles Davis, all very happy birthday this May 26th. And I hope you had as much fun watching that as I did. This is one of the coolest, you know, concert videos I've seen in a long time. And I think the last time I probably watched this was sometime back in the, I don't know, 90s or so, back when, you know, like BET Jazz had a channel. Maybe it was the early 2000s, BET Jazz was on, and you could watch these really cool concerts that just, people don't watch them anymore. They'll look at them. So I'm going to. Don't be surprised if there's another video from this show, from this concert, somewhere in the near future too. So anyway, with that said, hope you enjoyed it. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below, and know that I appreciate you and I wish you all well. Okay, take care.